Yo, what's good, basketball heads? It's your boy, Crush. Let's talk about the Nets, man. The Nets got to be one of the biggest failures in NBA history. The fact that they had Kevin Durant, James Harden, and Kyrie Irving on the same team and didn't win nothing. No rings, no finals appearance, nothing. How do you have three Hall of Famers in their prime on the same team, two regular season MVP, a finals MVP on the same team, and you get nothing? No finals appearance, no championship, nothing. So the Nets are practically in the rebuilding phase. That is insane, man. That is insane. That's what you call a failed organization. This team should have been, we should have been talking about, yo, I can't believe the Nets won it. You know, they did it. They won a ring. That should have been the narrative. Or, yo, man, that was a close finals, man. They almost did it. All we could talk about is what if. That is insane, man. How do you get this much talent on one team and come up short, basically? Nothing. Yes, there was some turmoil. You know, we get it. Kyrie didn't want to get vaccinated, et cetera, et cetera. But beyond that situation, how do you not get anything out of this? Not even the Eastern Conference Championship out of it? At least the Eastern Conference Championship. At least that. Even if you don't win the entire thing, at least a Eastern Conference Championship. So the Nets got nothing out of 4 years with three high-level max players. That is insane, man. That's a bust. This got to be one of the biggest busts in NBA history. So Kendrick Perkins said, this is one of the biggest busts in NBA history. And I agree. You had KD, James Harden, and Kyrie Irving on the same squad. And y'all got nothing for it, nothing to show for it. The Nets are practically rebuilding right now because obviously Kyrie just went to Dallas. Kevin Durant is hurt currently, so he's trying to get better. That is insane. And James Harden went to Philly like a year ago for Ben Simmons, who was a damn bum. He's a bench player. He sucks. Man, talk about bad moves. So they traded Ben Simmons for James Harden, which Ben Simmons is useless. He's a bench player. He's garbage. They brought Kyrie Irving in and Kevin Durant a few seasons ago. That didn't work out. They brought James Harden in. Then they had to trade him because James Harden got tired of all the extra nonsense. So he went to Philly. They brought Ben Simmons in, which is damaged goods because he's no longer, to me, Ben Simmons is no longer a starter. He's a bench player or a G League player. There's no way in hell you could tell me Ben Simmons is a starter. I'm sorry. No, he's not. Not anymore. Let's stop living in the past. We're in the now. And Ben Simmons is hot garbage. So the Nets lost James Harden a year ago. And instead of locking Kyrie Irving in for long term, give him the 4 year max, just lock him in, they pissed the man off and he requests a trade. So the Nets organization keep messing up. Like constant screw-ups and F-ups, man. Lock the man in for 4 years. Give him what he want. Give him the max contract. Lock him in. If you could get three more years out of him and Kevin Durant, great. That's a win-win regardless. That's a win-win. But the Nets organization was unwilling to do that and made Kyrie request a trade. Now he's in Dallas. The past four seasons, all this talent they acquired, they have zero to show for it. Nothing. This got to be one of the biggest disappointments in NBA history. I agree with Kendrick Perkins. It's got to be. This is insane, man. How do you mess something like this up? They basically had a super team, and they ruined it. The Nets literally had a super team. James Harden, Kyrie Irving, and Kevin Durant on the same team. And somehow they ruined that situation. Like, how? I mean, at least get a championship out of it. An Eastern Conference championship at worst. Nothing? No finals appearance? No Eastern Conference appearance? Nothing? That is crazy, man. I mean, that is crazy. This is an example of when stacking the deck goes wrong. LeBron tried to do the same thing in LA. That backfired on him with Russell Westbrook. The Brooklyn Nets tried to do the same thing in Brooklyn. And that backfired. The past few seasons, all these teams trying to stack the deck to win, and it's backfiring. Failed season, and it's sad, man. So So this is definitely one of the worst disappointment in NBA history. I do agree with Kendrick Perkins. This is crazy. This is crazy. The crazy part about the entire situation is James Harden demanded a trade. They made it happen. Swapped him out for Ben Simmons and picks. Gave up a lot for Ben Simmons. He's a scrub. Then last summer, Kevin Durant demanded a trade. Then he rescinded, had a change of heart. Now Kyrie Irving demanded a trade. Do you see the utter dysfunction? This is crazy. So everybody is demanding trades constantly. I mean, this is one of the most dysfunctional organizations, man. I've never seen anything like this. This is crazy. This team was supposed to be a dynasty. When we heard of Kyrie Irving going to Brooklyn, then Kevin Durant joining him, and then they move all those pieces to get James Harden, everybody's like, yeah, this team is going to win a few championships. So this was supposed to be the new dynasty of the NBA, and they have nothing to show for it. They never got to the NBA Finals, and this is a big disappointment. This is a big disappointment. Because this team was supposed to be competing for championships. We should have been saying, oh, I can't believe the Nets won, etc., etc. All we could say is, oh, I can't believe James Harden left. I can't believe Kyrie Irving left. That's all we could say. That's the story, basically. That is crazy, man. So this is what Kendrick Perkins had to say. If you think about what they gave up Caris LeVert, they gave up Jared Allen, and they gave up some picks to get James Harden. Then you get James Harden, and you give up for Ben Simmons, who has been irrelevant since he got to Brooklyn. And now all of a sudden, Kyrie Irving bounced on Kevin Durant, who has had his back the entire time throughout all the drama that Kyrie caused. This is the biggest disappointment in NBA history. When it comes down to a big three like them forming together, they got zero accomplished, winning no real series, making it into the conference finals, barely even playing games together. Hands down, the biggest disappointment I have ever seen. So that's what Kendrick Perkins had to say. And I do agree, man. This is one of the biggest disappointments I've seen in a long time. You brought three superstars together. Not stars. Three superstars together in their prime, the peak of their powers. And you have no finals appearance, no Eastern Conference appearance, no championships, nothing. So this entire time, it was a waste of time, basically. So you wasted 4 years, four seasons doing nothing. Brooklyn was better off with the team they had prior to making all those moves. They were better off with the team they had prior to acquiring James Harden. Brooklyn should have stuck with what they had when they had Kyrie Irving. Eventually, Kevin Durant came in, and they had those pieces. Jared Allen, Caris LeVert, etc. They should have stuck with that. They had a deep bench, a deep core. They broke that entire situation up to accommodate James Harden, and then he wanted out. Then Kyrie Irving wanted out. Kevin Durant wanted out last summer. This is the worst. This is one of the worst things I've ever seen. This is crazy. So you did all that for nothing, basically. All for nothing. So they did all this moving around, all these trades, all this, and you have zero to show for it. No hardware, no finals appearance, nothing. So 4 years of wasted time and energy. Yeah, this is sad, man. This is sad. If you're a Brooklyn fan, you should be pissed the hell off right now. All New York, all Brooklyn fans should be pissed off. Because this is some sad situation. But yeah, man. As always, I'll holla. As always, we just talking basketball. Hit the subscribe button. Like, comment, share. Holla at your boy.
It's all about the game and how you play it. It's all about the game. I'ma say it. It's all about the game.